So the HDRP module in Unity, HDRP is high definition render pipeline in Unity. And what does that mean? That means that we can hit the microphone really hard. So that means that we can have a look at materials. These are Unity based materials, at close up and hold them up to the light. Literally throw shadows and let's have a look at what else we can do with it. Sunshine coming in and creating a lens flare and glow effect. As you can see here, there's a lens flare. And for instance, here I have a car paint in my hand. It's anti-aliased. It looks very, very good from close up. So the way a designer would look at this is they would look at surfaces in the light. So you can literally, for example, if I take my ball and I go over there, I need something shiny for that. Or maybe this one will work. So I go over there to my light studio. So I created a literally light box studio for designers so that we can walk up to the light. And then as a designer would look at surfaces like class A surfaces, hold it in your hand, pass it around. And then literally, if I wanted to get a little closer or a little further away, now you see there's still some shadow artifacts. It literally changes. It's good to do it with a reflective surface, actually. So let's grab this one. And as you can see, this is a custom built studio where I can kind of play with these surfaces. And I can see the reflection of the room around me with the light box. And as you can see, the proximity to this light box really changes how I would review my surfaces. As I'm designing, this is traditionally the way that we would look at models, that we would look at painted models in a light situation, that we would review final parts even. Now, can you imagine if you can do this process way up front in a custom-made studio for you with your personal color palette right there with you and review all these amazing materials and apply them to your designs in a way that have fabrics as well. And it's not just for car designers or shoe designers. I think HDRP gives us the ability to create much more depth for reviews, whether it's with Vario or even a Quest 2. Currently, I'm running this from a Quest 2 on a PC link cable, which is only $100 or so. And this is a 1.3 gig file studio. As you can see, I've got high frame rates per second. There's no collider on that. It's totally customizable. And the atmosphere here with a little bit of fog in it is just stunning. So with that, I would love to end on a note that is, now I'm going to bash my microphone in, of course, to say, not a strike. But yeah, welcome. I've built this for HP. And I think there's a specific insight here for designers that always look for perfect light studios. I'm just going to walk around this. And as you can see now, the light box behind me, I hit the microphone again, but I see the reflection of everything. And this is not a miracle work, but it is very, fairly tricky to control. And now we have the ability to customize this for you and to create studios fairly rapidly. Of course, then we're going to go into self-generative design, self-generative systems in these spaces as well. But design studios to review class A surfaces is going to be absolutely mind-blowing with this. And we have the ability to code, to build rapidly with you, and to miss some pins as well. Now, these two have a secret to them that only I know, which is they're both... These are magic balls. Why are they magic balls? Let me see if I can show you. Only these, come on, brother, can stack. There's only two balls that stack here, and you have to find which ones that are. The floor is a little bit raised so that you can indeed grab the balls a little easier. And come on. These pins are heavy. Hey, I just saw a little, that was actually a little pass through. So there you have it, sunshine materials physics-based lighting, which means these spotlights have lumen just like they would in real life. Linens, materials, and things. Now, the speed that I walk through it is not going to come through in the video. You have to see this in VR and experience it and this is the low end, you know, Quest 2. Quest Pro, Reverb, Vario, obviously, the hardware is there. The ability to optimize and build is a fairly tricky deal because I even had to crack a certain code to get the materials library to work. I couldn't find any documentation on it. And the story